1.1 matrices and vectors. We will talk about some notation and give some definitions. Please pay special attention to the definitions. We will be using these quite often in later sections and chapters. So please bear with me even if you are quite familiar with all these things. In the video, you will find some questions asked. Please pause the video to think about these questions before you proceed. A matrix is simply a rectangular array of real numbers, and we will only talk about real matrices in this book. For example, A is this matrix here. Then we say the size of this matrix is 3 by 2, and this is called a row vector. This matrix has three rows, 1, 5, 4, 2, and 3, 6. And this is called a column. So this matrix has two columns, 1, 4, 3, and 5, 2, 6. And we will use the notation aij to denote the ij entry of A. For example, a21 would be this element here. So a21 is equal to 4. And we will call these entries scalars. The scalars are simply real numbers in this book. Notation. We will use capital letters, uppercase capital letters, to denote matrix. Suppose we have two matrices, A and B. Both of them are n by n. We say matrix A is a square. If m is the same as n, then A is a square matrix. And we say two matrices, A and B, are equal. We use the notation A equal to B. If they are of the same size, and aij is the same as bij for all ij. When A and B are of the same size, we can sum them up. The sum of A matrix and B matrix is an n by n matrix, also an n by n matrix, whose ij entry is aij plus bij. So for example, C is equal to A plus B, the sum of A and B, then Cij is Aij plus Bij. Suppose C is a scalar, the scalar multiple of A, Ca, is the n by n matrix whose ij entry is C times Aij. For example, B is a scalar multiple, Ca, then Bij is equal to C times Aij. For the special case that C is minus 1, then the scalar multiple minus 1a will simply be denoted like this, minus a. And we consider the special case that C is equal to 0. Then the scalar multiple 0a will be a matrix of all zeros, and that is the n by n zero matrix. We call this zero matrix. And we use the notation big 0. This is the big 0. So 0a is equal to big 0. And this big zero matrix, this zero matrix, is a matrix of all zero. The transpose of A, denoted by A transpose, is an n by n matrix. A is n by n. And the transpose of A is n by n matrix, whose ij entries is aji. For example, A is this matrix, and B is A transpose. A is 3 by 2, so B is 2 by 3. The rows of A becomes the columns of A. 1, 4 comes here, 2, 5 comes here, and 3, 6 comes here, like so. A question. We have this matrix. This is the transpose of A transpose. What would be this matrix? We will leave this as an exercise. We have a reading assignment here, Theorem 1.1 and 1.2. Please read them up. Now let's talk about vectors. A row vector is a special kind of matrix. It's an 1 by n matrix. For example, this is a row vector. And a column vector is an n by 1 matrix. This is an example of a column vector. And in the book, you will find boldface lowercase is used to denote a vector. So this is the notation of a vector in the book, boldface. So it's thick, like so. But it's more difficult for me to draw thick letters here, so I will use a different notation instead. What we will use here is lowercase with an underbar to denote a vector. V with an underbar. So this is a vector. And one more notation. The notation Rn will denote the set of all n by 1 vectors. N by 1 vectors, and this is n. Or we can write Rn in this form. It's a set that is a collection of all n by 1 vectors, x1 to xn. Those are the entries in the vectors. And this is for all xi in R, in real numbers. For all xi in R. And when we have an n by n matrix, we know it contains n column vectors. And sometimes it's more convenient to write out the column vectors a1 to an. Or we can also say it contains m row vectors. Each of these column vectors is a vector in Rm. For example, we have a matrix here. Then it contains column vector. The first column vector A1 will be 1, 2, 3. The second column vector is 4, 5, 6. Or we may write A in terms of row vectors. This D1 transpose is the first row vector of A all the way to Dm transpose, because A has m row vectors. And each of these Di transpose is a row vector. And that will make Di a column vector. And it's a column vector in Rn. If we use this example of A matrix here, then the first row vector is 1, 4. D1 transpose is 1, 4. So D1 is 1, 4. And D2 will be the second row vector. D2 transpose is the second row vector here. So D2 is 2, 5. And D3 is 3, 6. A question. Suppose A is n by n and B is A transpose. For A, we write out its column vectors A1 to AN, and for B, we write out its row vectors B1 to BN, because A is N by N, so that will make B N by M, so it has N row vectors, and this time these BI are the row vectors, so BI are row vectors themselves. How are B1 to BN related to A1 to AN? In the last part of 1.1, let's talk about geometry of vectors. Suppose we have a vector in R2 and the entries are A and B, then V can be represented as an arrow from the origin to the point AB in the XY plane. So we have the XY plane here, and we have A here and B here. Then we can represent V as an arrow to the point AB. This is V vector. If we use this representation, then it's very easy to get the sum of two vectors using parallelogram law. Consider the sum of two vectors U and V. Use this vector, and V is vector. We form the parallelogram using the vectors V and U, and this arrow along the diagonal of the parallelogram is the vector U plus V. It is also very easy to see a scalar multiple of a vector V. CV is equal to CA CB. And suppose we have V vector here, then CV will simply be a vector along the line formed by the vector V. Here I have drawn an example when C is a negative number. We say two vectors U and V are parallel if U is a scalar multiple of V. A question. Let's consider the set L. L is the collection of all scalar multiples of V. So it's a set of the form CV for all C in R. What would be L? Suppose this is V, and what is L? L is the collection of all scalar multiples of V. So it's the collection of all the points on the line formed by the vector V. So it's simply the whole line formed by the vector V.